morning. Myself Shalini Garg, lecturer electronics, Government Polytechnic College, Jodhpur. आज हम 885 के इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट में से ब्रांच ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस डिस्कस करेंगे. ओवरव्यू ऑफ ब्रांच इंस्ट्रक्शंस. नॉर्मली माइक्रोप्रोसेसर सीक्वेंस में इंस्ट्रक्शंस एग्जीक्यूट करता है, बट इन केस ऑफ ब्रांच इंस्ट्रक्शन माइक्रोप्रोसेसर चेंजेस अ सीक्वेंस either conditionally or unconditionally to a different memory location and thereafter it continues execution from that location. Yani suppose yahan par hum ek ye chhota sa program dekhen. These are the sets of instruction. Sabse pehle microprocessor ye instruction in sequence mein execute kar raha hai. There are three branch instructions: jump instructions, call and return instructions and the restart instruction. तो ये तीन instruction execute करने के बाद जैसे ही it encounters jump instruction, thereafter it transfers the control to memory location 3050 और उसके बाद इस memory location से sequence में program execute करेगा. 2009 onwards जो भी इंस्ट्रक्शन आ रहे हैं माइक्रोप्रोसेसर उनको स्किप कर देगा. दिस इज अनकंडीशनल जंप. जंप भी जंप इंस्ट्रक्शन आएगा माइक्रोप्रोसेसर जो उस इंस्ट्रक्शन के आगे एड्रेस दिया हुआ है इट विल ट्रांसफर द कंट्रोल टू दैट मेमोरी लोकेशन. नाउ लेट अस सी द कंडीशनल जंप इंस्ट्रक्शन. हियर वी हैव अ सेट ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस. It executes one by one in sequence. Now, the next instruction is JC, which stands for jump on carry. This means microprocessor will jump to memory location 3050 if carry flag is 1. If carry flag is 1, program sequence is transferred to 3050, but if carry flag is 0, it will execute the next instruction in sequence. So this is conditional and unconditional jump. There are variety of conditional jump instructions. For unconditional jump there is only one instruction, that is JMP, aur us instruction ke aage jo bhi 16 bit address hoga program sequence is transferred to that memory location. Now let us have a look over the conditional jump instruction. JC stands for jump on carry, means it will jump if carry flag is 1. Jump on no carry, it will jump if carry flag is equal to 0. Similarly, jump on positive, it means it will jump if sign flag is 0. Jump on minus, it means it will jump to memory location followed by the jump instruction if sign flag is 1. Jump on 0 means it will jump if 0 flag is 1. Jump on not 0, it will jump if 0 flag is 0. Jump on parity even, JPE, that means it will jump if parity flag is 1. Jump on parity odd, JPO, it will jump if parity flag is 0. Each conditional jump instruction is followed by 16 bit address and the program sequence is transferred to this 16-bit address if the condition is true. Otherwise, the normal sequence of execution continues. Next, overview of call instruction. Call instructions are used to call a subroutine program either conditionally or unconditionally. The program sequence is transferred to a subroutine, but after completing the subroutine, it comes back to the original position from where it is called. Now let us see an example. Suppose we have a program written from memory location 2000 onwards. Now the sequence of instructions are executed in sequence. Now as soon as a call instruction comes, call 2090, the program is transferred to memory location 2090. But before transferring to memory location 2090, the content of next the memory location of the next instruction, that is the content of the program counter 2009, are stored onto the stack. Stack pointer is decremented by one, and higher order value of program counter is stored in SP-1 memory location. Next, again, SP is again decremented by one, and lower order value of program counter 09 is stored in memory location SP-2, and new value of stack pointer is SP-2. Now, 2090 is stored in temporary register W and Z. This value is placed on the address bus, and after saving the content of program counter onto the stack, the next instruction is executed from memory location 2090, and program counter is automatically upgraded to the next memory location, that is 2091. So program is executed from 2090 onwards in sequence until it encounters the return instruction. Jaise hi return instruction aayega, the program, the microprocessor pops out the value of the program counter jo usne stack mein store ki thi, and the program is returned back to the main program jahan se usne call se jahan se ब्रेक हुआ था और प्रोग्राम सीक्वेंस नेक्स्ट मेमोरी लोकेशन पे ट्रांसफ़र हुई थी, उसके नेक्स्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन पे प्रोग्राम वापस से ट्रांसफ़र हो जाएगा। देर आफ्टर इट्स एग्जीक्यूट्स द इंस्ट्रक्शन इन सीक्वेंस। सपोज वापस से एक कॉल इंस्ट्रक्शन आ गया, अगेन दिस 2090 इज सेव्ड इन डब्ल्यू एंड जेड रजिस्टर, एंड देन वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रोग्राम काउंटर विच नाउ इन दिस केस इज 2008 is saved onto the stack, and the program sequence is transferred again to memory location 2090. Thereafter, the program is executed in sequence from 2090 onwards until it encounters the return instruction. As soon as it encounters the return instruction, microprocessor pops out the value of program counter जो कि उसने stack पे save की थी. Now in this case it is 200E. So the program sequence is transferred to memory location 200E, and from there it executes the instruction in sequence. Next, conditional and unconditional call instruction. There is only one unconditional call instruction, which is followed by 16-bit address. The program sequence is transferred from the main program to the calling program. कॉल के बाद जो 16-bit एड्रेस दिया होगा, प्रोग्राम उस मेमोरी लोकेशन पे ट्रांसफर हो जाएगा. बट बिफोर ट्रांसफरिंग, द एड्रेस ऑफ द नेक्स्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन आफ्टर कॉल इज पुश्ड ऑनटू द स्टैक, सो दैट as soon as it encounters return instruction, it can return to the main program. Then there is a set of conditional call instruction. Call on carry CC, that means it will call the subroutine if carry flag is 1. CNC, call on no carry, that means the subroutine, it will jump to the subroutine if value of carry flag is 0. CP, call on positive, that means it will call subroutine if sign flag is 0. Call on minus CM, it will call the subroutine if sign flag is 1. CZ, call on 0, that means it will call the subroutine if 0 flag is 1. Call on no 0, that means it will call the subroutine if 0 flag is 0. Call on parity even, it will call subroutine if parity flag is 1. And call on parity odd, that means it will call the subroutine and execute the subroutine if parity flag is 0. If the condition is true, the subroutine is called from the 16-bit address, which follows the conditional call instruction, and before transferring the control to the subroutine, the content of the program counter are saved onto the stack, so that as soon as it encounters the return instruction, it returns back to the next instruction after the call instruction. Next, overview of return instruction. Return instruction be two types ke hain, unconditional return and conditional return. Jaise hi return instruction hoga, it inserts two byte from top of the stack into the program counter and increments the stack pointer by 2. Now let us have a look here over a sample program. Suppose the instructions are stored from memory location 2000 onwards. So these instructions are executed in sequence until it encounters a call instruction called 2090. That means it will jump to memory location 2090, but before transferring the control to memory location 2090, the memory address of the next instruction, that is move C,A, which is 2009, is saved onto the stack. And this 2090 is saved in temporary register W and Z. Once 2009 is saved onto the stack, the program sequence is transferred to memory location 2090 and it executes instruction from 2090 in sequence until it encounters the return instruction. Jaise hi return instruction aayega, ye jo value hai, this is popped out from the stack placed on W and Z register, which is placed on the address bus, and the program sequence is again transferred to memory location 2009. Automatically, program counter is upgraded to 2000A and instructions are executed in sequence. Again, it encounters a call instruction to the same memory location, but now the address of the next instruction is 2000E. So this 2000E is saved onto the stack. The program is transferred to the memory location 2090. Sequence of instructions are executed, and as soon as the return instruction is encountered, the program is again transferred to memory location 2000E by popping the content of stack. Conditional and unconditional return instruction. Unconditional return instruction is RET. There is no operand and it returns from the subroutine unconditionally. The program sequence is transferred from the subroutine to the calling program. Then we have a set of conditional call instructions. Return instruction, return on carry, that is it returns if carry flag is 1. Return on no carry, it returns if carry flag is 0. Return on positive, it returns if sign flag is 0. Return on minus means it returns if sign flag is 1. RZ stands for return on 0, that is it will return to the main program if 0 flag is 1. Return on non-zero, it will return if 0 flag is 0. Return on parity even, RPE, that means it will return to the main program if parity flag is 1. Return on parity odd, it will return to the main program if parity is 0. The sequence is again transferred to the main program. Then next, restart instruction. Restart instructions are 1 byte call instructions, and these are used as software instructions in the program to transfer the execution to one of the locations predefined on page 0. 8085 we have 8 software interrupts from RST0 to RST7, in all 8 software interrupts, which are 1 byte call instruction. Jaise hi hum RST0 denge, that means the program sequence is transferred to memory location 000H. The instruction format is RSTN, where N may be 0 to 7. The corresponding memory location is 8 into N. For example, RST4 means memory location जहाँ पे प्रोग्राम सीक्वेंस ट्रांसफर होगी, इट इज़ 4 × 8 विच इज़ 32 इन डेसिमल एंड इज इक्वल टू 20 इन हेक्साडेसिमल, दैट इज 0020 इन हेक्साडेसिमल। सिमिलरली फॉर RST7, द रीस्टार्ट एड्रेस इज 7 × 8, 7 इज n, 8 से मल्टीप्लाई करने पे इट गेट 56 इन डेसिमल विच इज इक्वल टू 38 इन हेक्साडेसिमल, and so the restart address for RST7 is 0038. Before transferring the control to the restart address, the content of program counter are saved onto the top of the stack. Now, there is an assignment for the students. Identify the value of program counter after execution of each of the following instructions, assuming initial value of program counter is 4050. First instruction is move A, C. Now initial value of program counter is 4050. So this instruction is stored in memory location 4050. It is a 1-byte instruction. So after execution of this instruction, value of program counter will be 4051. So the next instruction, subtract L, will be stored in memory location 4051. Again, sub L is a 1-byte instruction. Automatically, after execution of sub L, program counter is incremented by 1, and so the new value of PC will be 4052. Now, the next instruction is MVI A,65. This instruction is stored in memory location 4052, and MVI A,65 is a 2-byte instruction क्योंकि एक byte opcode आएगी और दूसरी byte ये इमीडिएट डेटा होगी, तो इसमें हम दो ऐड करेंगे टू कैलकुलेट द न्यू वैल्यू ऑफ प्रोग्राम काउंटर, दैट इज 4052 प्लस 2 व्हिच बिकम्स 4054। नाउ द नेक्स्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन इज जंप 6980। इन केस ऑफ जंप द प्रोग्राम सीक्वेंस इज ट्रांसफर्ड अनकंडीशनली टू मेमोरी लोकेशन 6980, सो द न्यू वैल्यू ऑफ प्रोग्राम काउंटर विल बी 6980। Thereafter, we assume the subsequent instructions are stored in memory location 6980. Now, LXI H3400, if it is stored in memory location 6980, it is a 3-byte instruction. So after this instruction, program counter will be incremented by 3, that is 6980 plus 3. So the new value of program counter will be 6983. Now the next instruction is call 9000. This is again unconditional branch instruction which transfers the control to memory location 9000. So value of program counter is 9000 after call 9000. So that's all about branch instructions. Thank you.